Hi everyone, and welcome to another episode of New Earth Living. Today we are going to be looking at how to see our natural and wild environment in a new light. And that is basically maybe an introduction for some of you to enter into the world of wild edibles, wild medicinal plants, and really take advantage of what nature offers us so freely and abundantly. But not just take advantage in any way, but also from the heart. And that's what New Earth Living is all about. Heart-centered and living in a sustainable way with ourselves, with nature, and with each other. Many of us, the truth is, today in our society, are not born loving a natural interaction with nature. As soon as we go outside, pretty much anywhere, if we see a bug or some kind of an insect, we, you know, want to shoo them away or even kill them. We want to spray ourselves with lots of chemicals. We want to, of course, spray our grasses, our fields, our lawns with chemicals. We want to rip stuff out. We want to discriminate against it, call it weeds, not understanding fully its amazing impact and potential. And so again, from a young age, typically we are taught to fear nature, to control nature, to dominate nature, and basically that nature really isn't that important. Yeah, it's just something out there, but there's more important things like getting the right education, getting a six-figure income, driving the best car, or whatever the case may be. But if we really think about it, if we expand our consciousness, when we open our heart, we start to realize that without all of this, there would be none of this. There would be none of what we see on this planet in terms of how beautiful and wonderful life can be. Your food, your medicines, your happiness and well-being depends on nature to pretty much a full degree, other than the human-to-human interaction that so many of us thrive off of as well. And so my personal journey when it comes to interacting with nature was like most people. I didn't like insects. I feared some of them, perhaps. I tried to, you know, spend as little time in kind of messy environments, natural environments as possible, and basically, you know, enjoy that perfectly manicured cut lawn. But then, of course, as so many of us go through our different transformations and awakenings, part of my journey included going from someone who didn't want really anything to do with gardening. I didn't even want to be bothered with landscaping, the artificial kind, but still. And when my moment of transformation took place on a heart level, on a mind level, on a body level, on a spirit level, amazing things happened. So much so that as I grew and expanded, it brought me to a place where I saw my natural environment in a brand new light from a completely different perspective. Today, when I look at a perfectly cut, manicured, monoculture lawn of just plain grass, I can't help but feel that, you know, something is missing there. And what's missing is the beauty, the diversity of nature. Today, when I look at fields like this, which isn't actually a wild field, but my very home surroundings, this is where I feel there's so much life, so much vibrance, so much beauty, and so much potential. You may not be at a place yet where you can look at a wild field like this or what's supposed to be somebody's grass or lawn and appreciate it. You might think, how can anybody survive in this, what looks maybe chaotic to some people? And I completely understand because I was once there too. But today I look at this and I think, I can't imagine it any other way. I've kind of always, you know, in the back of my mind, admired natural fields of wildflowers. And today I'm living amongst them. When we look at nature and how she provides, everything grows freely. I don't have to do anything to maintain it. And that's what's so amazing as well, is we can have the most beautiful flowers, the most beautiful and nutritious foods, and even medicines. We just have to take, of course, some care, awareness, and educate ourselves just a little bit in terms of what is around us. And how does it work and live with us? So in the last couple of years, one of my biggest passions has been exploring the world of wild edibles and basically coming to the full realization that if we are living on or around an area that has naturally growing greens, flowers, herbs, plants of any kind, we might have no idea what they do or how they work. In fact, most of us probably fear them or are in some way grossed out by, oh my gosh, we can't touch that, we can't eat that because it could have A, B, C, or D on it. That's a whole different story. But when we start to take appreciation, take notice, and take interest in what grows around us and how it can impact and benefit our life, we start to open up to the world of so much potential where you can have free food, free medicine, and both of a higher quality than anything pretty much that your drugstore or grocery store will provide. And of course, we change internally ourselves because no longer is there the feeling or the intent to rip and destroy and call something a weed. Now we change the perspective to see everything as the life, the precious, sacred life that it is, and appreciate the beauty that it holds, whether it's yellow or white or green or this shade of green or that shade of green. And so on my journey of learning about my natural surroundings and learning about how this field for me now is impossible to be destroyed or cut or you know, damaged in some way, because I see the potential of the earth, of Mother Nature offering my food for me, my enjoyment and pleasure in the beauty that I see before me. And even as I learn and come back to how humans can interact in harmony and balance with their natural environment, medicinal healing potential. So where can you begin? Well, today the best part is that there's so many amazing resources, which I will be sharing with you, just a few of them at the end of our video today. But in general, I just wanted to show you how beautiful and amazing the world of wild edibles can be. For example, the clovers, purplish pink or red clover as they're sometimes called, or the white clovers. So much nutritional potential and medicinal healing properties, including the flowers like this daisy, also not just edible, but also has some medicinal properties. When we look around, we can also see so many different common plants like the dandelion, which many people still regard as a weed, when in fact it's a powerful cleanser, detoxifier, an amazing food source for your salads or your smoothies, as well contains incredible healing potential. We also can look at the plantain family, which there's so many different kinds all around, and appreciate as well their healing potential and edible benefits. And the list goes on and on. And so where can you start to really put this to practice in your own life? Well, a few places. For starters, if we are going to come back to living with nature in a balanced way, in a harmonious way, the first place we need to start is with ourselves. You're not going to be able to appreciate this or even feel comfortable with it if you don't start from within first. That means an opened heart and a change in your mind, a change in how you view and see, a change in perspective. Because once we have that transformation within, then we are open to the possibility and the potential that lies before us. But until then, you might have the best intentions at trying to say, okay, well, I know this is edible, but I still feel maybe, oh, gross or icky that, you know, it's just growing out there. The other aspect is that if the heart and the mind don't guide you to this journey, then fear is always going to be the underlying and the prevalent sort of dictator in how you interact with your natural environment and how you make use of the wild edibles and medicinal plants. Because very quickly you might again think, oh, I heard this is edible, but it could be poisonous and kill me. It can take on so many different forms in how that fear manifests. Just even self-doubt. And remember, our mind is so powerful that even if something is fully safe and fully edible, just that doubt in your mind can create a stomach issue that day. So we have to understand that it has to start with our mind, a change in perspective, and with a more open heart to appreciating and loving nature. Now, how can you have that change in perspective, you might be thinking? It doesn't just happen overnight. Well, it can for some people, depending on how your transformational journey and awakening has been taking place thus far. But for most, you're right. It's going to take some interest, some level of, you know, perhaps curiosity about your natural environment, that maybe you'll start reading a blog about natural wild edible plants. Maybe a friend will know of some book or a local workshop to visit and take part in. So education for sure on this front is very, very important. And that can be a huge catalyst for you changing your mind and changing your perspective about how you view the natural world when it comes to it providing your food, your medicine, and so much more. The second place is, of course, making sure that we, through that open heart, learn to appreciate every single being unconditionally and equally. That means that a daisy is no more or less special than the clover, no more or less special than a grass blade, no more or less special than the plantain or the vetch or the, you know, aster or whatever the case may be. Every single plant has a role. Every single plant has an incredible role, in fact, and a perfect reason to be present. So even if you learn something along the way that maybe this plant is poisonous or toxic, which is in fact very few out in nature, and very few that actually are, you know, dangerous to the point of serious effects of killing us, when we really learn how they work and how to work with them. At a time when so many of us are wondering about food stability in terms of sustainability for the future and how are we going to be able to feed the planet or just feed ourselves, all of us know that if transportation was cut off for any reason, basically that means your grocery store supply is cut off pretty instantly. So then what would we do? And this is where a lot of people are being called to explore the world of wild edibles. By exploring this world, we begin to see the potential that it offers for us so freely and so abundantly. In fact, depending on where you live, you can find so many amazing foods and medicines that you can use every day yourself, as long as, of course, you take some proper care and interest in learning about them, to make anything from amazing salads, like from this amazing wild sorrel that is growing here, that has a beautiful lemony flavor to it, to so many of the other plants that we have in our surroundings. And I really like how a lot of the experts who have come before many of us who are just getting excited about this journey for ourselves have all stated the same sort of conclusion, that everything you need to survive is, generally speaking, growing in and around your most immediate area. So look around, get interested in perhaps your garden, in perhaps your front yard, backyard, depending, of course, where you live and what it may look like. If it's a monoculture lawn, well, there isn't going to be much, but you can change that. And this is another driving force where more and more people are getting interested in wild gardening or wild landscaping or wild and edible landscaping, where you can grow food, where you can grow things that are going to provide value to you, to be sustainable for the long term. Because as we know, monoculture lawns are one of the most unsustainable resources that we keep investing so much of our other resources in, like time, money, and water, things like that. These natural wild plants, for example, they don't need to be ever watered. The only thing that is ever going to affect them is if some massive, and we're talking like a serious drought, came about, because they have such amazing resilience and they know how to survive given the different surroundings. So I invite you to really take another look at the world of wild edibles and get interested, get excited, get curious about what grows around you and how you can use it. Because most of us have no idea how much free medicine and free food is around us. To understand our wild plants as medicine, yes, it's going to take some interest and research and a serious education on your part. And by that, I don't mean a full degree of any kind, but basically picking up some good books from some good experts. But when it comes to understanding many of these wild edibles as food, there are so many resources that most of us can be comfortable within, you know, just a few short hours or after just a few good resources to have top 5 wild edibles that we can include as part of our diet on a regular basis. So why do you want to get interested in the world of wild edibles? Each of our reasons may be unique, but on the foundational level, I suspect they're all going to be very, very similar. as we progress on our planet into the next decade, throughout this decade, and think about not just our life, our life quality, we also start to think about future generations and what we are pre-paving for them. We know that today's typical landscaping is extremely unsustainable, both financially for many people and also from the standpoint of water resources, in terms of the fertilizer, still chemical sprays and different agents that people add to them. This is all, of course, making it right back to us through into our water, into our air, into our soil, and into our food. Making sure that we are making the most sustainable choices is going to be a key driving factor for many people. And this is where, again, one of the easiest things that you can do, a step, an action in your life, is to consider that if you have a monoculture lawn that you have to keep putting and investing your time and money into, consider changing that or trading it in for a wild garden or a wild edible garden or for just a regular edible garden. Many people throughout the US and Canada are doing just that as we speak, as well as other parts of the world, where we are seeing the value that if we are going to be taking care of a piece of land and putting our time and money and resources into it, why not have it also give us one of the most essential things for us, that is our food. Another one is, of course, just the plain and simple, wonderful benefit that you can have free food. And it is so abundant and it never runs out and it can serve you for so many seasons, whether it's the spring, summer season, right into the fall and winter season. And this is especially important and critical for those of you who are really wanting to get sustainable and accountable and responsible for your own personal choices and food supply. As more and more of us learn and come back to a respectful, harmonious relationship with nature, we realize how simply we can help our body heal. Of course, I'm not necessarily talking about the big things or chronic diseases, etc., even though the plants can help us with anything. But something that you can do comfortably and easily on a daily basis, like how to treat a cut, how to treat an insect sting, how about if you have some joint pain, your local wild plants can be used for all that and more. And it just takes, again, just some interest, curiosity, and learning on your part. And finally, why else do you want to get interested in the world of wild edibles? Because as we do, we come back to living the most harmoniously with nature. So whatever your reasons may be, I do encourage you to perhaps consider this journey if it's the first time you're hearing about it, or keep at it if you have already started your journey into understanding the world of wild edibles. So as a final tip and piece of advice, I'd love to share with you just a few good resources where you can begin your journey or continue your journey depending on what point you are at. The first place to start would be getting some kind of a local plant guidebook. These types of books are fantastic at helping you identify the plants in your area, but at the same time, you have to know their limitations, that they won't always be either open to or just won't have the information in terms of what is edible, what part of the plant is edible, and how safe is it, etc. So what these types of local guidebooks can do for you is basically help you identify the plant and learn first what is growing in your area. To understand the plants on a better basis, you would have to go to a book. For example, the one I have here is Magic and Medicine of Plants. This is an old resource and there's so many other ones in terms of how to use the plants. So these types of books are more in depth in terms of not just identification or helping you identify your plant, but helping you understand what part of it to use, how, when, what form, and how, what it can be good for. Now, other experts are also fantastic in terms of local workshops or perhaps seeing them live or seeing YouTube videos. Lots of people today have fantastic YouTube videos. One expert on wild edibles is, for example, Marcus Rothkranz. And Marcus Rothkranz, as well as Gary Thiebel, have put together this fantastic 6-DVD set called Free Living 101. And Marcus Rothkranz also has a new book he just put out about free food and medicine, as well as some other DVDs. So you can visit his website and you can hear him talk about some of these in a previous video interview that I did with him. Gary Thiebel, whereas Marcus is located in the US, Gary Thiebel is located in Canada. And if you want to hear from somebody super passionate and excited who knows what they're talking about, how to get into the world of wild edibles, I definitely recommend this resource. if you don't want to purchase anything, if you don't want to perhaps go out of your way, how about starting with some blogs? There are today an amazing amount of diverse resources that are free online from people just like you and I who are at different parts of their journey into the world of wild edibles and learning about them, learning how to appreciate them, and of course, sharing with others to help them also gain the benefits from this amazing world. So thanks so much for joining me. I definitely will be creating more videos and to help you understand different parts of the plants, how to really work with them. Because again, as this has become such a big part of my life and one of my leading and guiding passions, I want to share all that with you and help you on your journey as well to get the amazing benefits on a physical, mental, emotional, and of course, spiritual level when it comes to the beautiful world that surrounds us each day. Take care, everyone. Until next time.